velvet cloak of night shrouds the London airport. All is quiet, all is serene. But this is the lull before the storm. Thousands of Beatles fans are bedded down for the night to await the arrival of their heroes. When the dawn comes up, like a teenage scream, the arrival of the froggy-voiced foursome is imminent. The cries of the crowd grow in pitch and volume, drowning out the whine of the jet engines. And here they are, fresh from their triumphant appearances in the United States. 12,000 young Britons roar a welcome. Their shrieks rise in an awesome wave. Our staff scientist, in an odd moment, calculated that this young mob is generating enough energy to put 3 Atlas missiles in orbit and power 54,000 transistor radios. Some of the fences hold, others do not. A minor miracle is mounted by the fact that there are no injuries spread among the near hysterical crowd. This truly is a social document for our time. The young ladies fainted, but authorities feel that some were playing possum so that they might be lifted over the fence and thus be nearer their idols. The Beatles, who originated as a small-time act out of Liverpool, now have no rivals as the kingpins of the teenage set. You can repeat that loud and long. Some brave volunteers among the British police elect to act with heroism above and beyond the call of duty and escort the Beatles to their car. There hasn't been this much excitement at the London airport since man learned to fly. So there you have the homecoming of the Beatles, the return of the heroes to their native land. They did what the Redcoats couldn't do in the American Revolution. They conquered the colonies.